Hello, dear students. It's your teacher Ankita Kalia, and in today's lecture, I'll be taking Unit 4, that is Settlement of International Commercial Dispute. Let's proceed. Introduction. The party should be aware that the disagreement and dispute can arise at any time. Therefore, in the process of concluding an international economic agreement, the party should note the provision on the selection method of dispute settlement if a dispute occurs. Basically, four dispute resolution methods in international trade, they are as follow: negotiation, mediation, commercial arbitration, and courts. So whenever there is a dispute, party should choose any of these methods to resolve their dispute. But in international commercial trade, the one of the best ways to resolve dispute is arbitration, as it is binding on parties and it is more authentic as compared to any other form of dispute resolution. Now we will start with the first one, that is mediation. It is a very simple, voluntary, party-centered and structured negotiation process where a neutral third party assists the parties in amicable resolving their disputes by using specified communication and negotiation techniques. The mediator only acts as a facilitator in helping the parties to reach a negotiated settlement of their dispute. The mediator makes no decision and does not impose his view of what a fair settlement should be. In mediation process, each side meets with an experienced neutral mediator. Mediation is a process where it is controlled by the parties themselves. So in nutshell, mediation is a very simple process whereby both the parties sit together and the third person is a mediator, who is a neutral person who does not impose any decisions, who does not utter a word even, but parties by themselves resolve the dispute by sitting in front of each other and decide the dispute. Now we go to the next one, that is conciliation. The process is flexible, allowing parties to define the time, structure, context of the conciliation proceeding. Conciliation is an alternative dispute resolution process whereby parties to a dispute use conciliator, who meets with the parties separately in order to resolve the dispute. So the conciliator basically goes separately to both the parties and get the opinions how to resolve the dispute. The conciliator does not decide for the parties but strives to support them in generating options in order to find a solution that is compatible to both the parties. So basically he tries to motivate, he's tried to gather options or ways in which the resolution, in which the dispute can be resolved. The process is risk-free and not binding on the parties till they arrive and sign the agreement. And once a solution is reached between the disputing parties before a conciliator, the agreement had the effect of an arbitration award and is legally tenable in any court in any country. So when the conciliation process reaches the final state, that is the agreement has been decided, the conclusions are being drawn by both the parties, it is having an arbitral award. So it becomes kind of binding on the parties afterwards. So that is conciliation. Now we proceed further, that is arbitration. Arbitration is a form of alternative dispute resolution, is a technique for resolution of dispute outside the court where parties to a dispute refer it to one or more person. Arbitrator is one by whose decision they agree to be bound. It is a resolution technique in which a third party reviews the evidence in the case and impose a decision that is legally binding for both sides and enforceable. So basically it means that both the parties will go to the arbitration place or tribunal where the arbitrator will be there, who is a neutral person. Neutral person means he is not having favor in either of the parties. He is not having favor towards any of the parties. And he will give the decision on the basis of evidence which are provided by the parties. Now we see the advantages of arbitration, and those can be summarized as follows. It is often faster than litigation in courts. Second one, it can be cheaper and more flexible for businesses. Third one, arbitral proceeding and arbitral award are generally non-public and can be confidential, so they are kept confidential amongst the parties only. In arbitral proceeding, the language of arbitration may be chosen, whereas in judicial proceedings, the official language remains the same. So these are some of the advantages. There are very limited avenues for appeal of an arbitral award. When the subject matter of dispute is highly technical, arbitrator with an appropriate degree of expertise can be appointed, as one cannot choose judge in litigation. So this is the ultimate power which is there in the arbitration. That is, the arbitrator can be chosen by the parties, whereas a judge cannot be chosen in litigation by the parties. So now we'll see some of the disadvantages of arbitration. Arbitration may be subject to pressure from the powerful parties. Supposingly there are two parties, one party is a superpower country, another is a developing country or underdeveloped country. So the superpower country can influence the arbitrator, and the arbitrator can give the decision in favor of the powerful country. So if the arbitration is mandatory and binding, the parties waive their right to access the court. So the because the arbitration is mandatory and binding, so the parties, once the decision is provided by arbitration, they cannot proceed to any court. In some arbitration agreements, the parties are required to pay for the arbitrators, which add an additional cost, and especially in small consumer disputes. So that will add on more expenditure, that will add on more burden on the parties to pay the arbitrator. There are very limited venues for appeal, which means an erroneous decision can be easily turned over. Just because the number of courts will be number of courts for arbitration is very less, the tribunals are very less, so that means they will have more burden, and when burden is a lot, they might give a defective decision in the favor of parties. So that can be erroneous decision passed by the arbitral courts or tribunals. Although usually thought to be speedier, when there are multiple arbitrators on the panel juggling their schedules for hearing dates in long cases can lead to delay. So when simply it means that when there are number of arbitrators, all the arbitrators will give different schedules, different dates for hearing the matters. So that will not make the process speedier, but that will slower down the process. Now we proceed further. Now in the case Cullens versus Cullen, the definition of arbitration was provided under the following case, and we'll see the definition says as, an arbitration is a reference to the decision of one or more person, either with or without an umpire. A particular matter is difference between the parties. It was further observed by the court that proceedings are structured for dispute resolution, wherein executives of the parties to dispute meets in presence of a neutral arbitrator, advisor, and on hearing both the sides and consideration the facts and merits of the dispute, an attempt is made voluntarily settlement. So in the general sense, the Cullens and Cullens case, it was decided that arbitration is something where there is an umpire who is neutral towards both the parties, and he gives the decision on the basis of hearing both the parties and the evidences provided by those parties. That is arbitration. Now we proceed further. Now there are three types of arbitration. That is domestic arbitration, international arbitration, and international commercial arbitration. So we'll start with the first one, that is domestic arbitration. Domestic arbitration is that type of arbitration which happens in a country or in India. Supposedly, when both the parties are from same nation, we can call it as domestic arbitration. So when both parties are from India and they're deciding to resolve their dispute by the way of arbitration, we can say they have adopted the domestic arbitration. So that is domestic arbitration. Now we proceed further. International arbitration. So what is international arbitration? So in very general words, international arbitration means when one of the parties is an international party and one of the party is a domestic party and both are having a dispute related to any matter, supposedly maritime border disputes or any disputes which needs to be resolved will be resolved by the international arbitration, and they choose an arbitrator either from either of the countries or from other countries. So that is how the international dispute is resolved. Now we come to international commercial arbitration. Now before we proceed, we need to know a little background of international commercial trade. So international commercial trade basically takes place between two different nations or two different countries. So when both the parties are foreign parties and both the parties are from different continents, they can adopt for international commercial dispute, and their dispute will be resolved through this way. Supposingly, one country is Asia, another is Europe. So there, both of the parties' dispute will be resolved by the third party, that is the third country. Supposingly, England is resolving their dispute. So the third party will be the neutral party, will be the arbitrator for both the nations. So that is how international commercial arbitration takes place. So that was international commercial arbitration. Now we proceed further. So what are the principal character of arbitration? Like, these are the essence of arbitration. Arbitration is consensual in nature. That means when both the parties have togetherly or when they have consented for arbitration, then only arbitration takes place. It does not happen on the consent of one party, but it requires consent of both the parties. So it is consensual in nature. Arbitration is neutral because the person, the arbitrator who is resolving the dispute, is neutral. He is not having interest. He is not trying to favor any of the countries, as both the countries are not supporting any of the countries. So thus he is neutral towards the decision or his opinion, whichever he will decide afterwards. So that is how arbitration is neutral in nature. Parties choose the arbitrator. When the parties form a contract for contracting, they put a clause in the contract that when there will be a dispute, the dispute will be resolved through arbitration. So that is how when the arbitration process starts happening, both the parties give one name each is given by both the parties, and the arbitrator is mutually decided by both the parties, and he is the one who resolves the dispute later on. The last point says decision of the arbitral tribunal is final and easy to enforce. As we know that arbitration process is binding on both the parties, it is decided by a neutral judge, and that is why it is easy to enforce, as both the parties are having obligation to comply with it. So now we proceed further. So these were the essence of the arbitration. Now, conclusion. In nutshell, whatever we have studied in the above slides, we can say that arbitration is one of the best ways in which international commercial disputes can be resolved, because it is binding in nature. Both the parties are having obligation to abide by it. It is authentic. It is. It supports the actual true sense of resolving the dispute, and the matter which is there in arbitration is also kept confidential, and thus for international commercial disputes the best form of dispute resolution is arbitration, which is followed in the international commercial law. So that's all. This was the conclusion of the slide.